what they did illegally, and they say that you have to deport because you was put in prison. I don't know if you understand.
Yes, I think I do. But the worrying thing, you mentioned children who are caught up in all of this, Michalis, and there have been some very worrying cases recently of children who've been separated from their parents because the parents have been deported. What happens to the children in these cases? Because that is against what little I do know of all European family law.
I have one case that the mother, a European citizen, was arrested illegally in front of her child. The Commissioner for the Protection of Child issued a very catapult against immigration. 6th of August, this poor girl, 23 years old, the mother of a child under 3 years old, she was arrested in the immigration department, and the father came to take the child. They put her in prison just saying that it's a marriage of convenience. The poor father, a Pakistan national, he didn't have any other choice rather than to have a DNA test, even if he didn't have the obligation to, because the birth certificate of Cyprus Republic considered him to be the father. So it's unbelievable that there is a legal document saying that this man is the father. So you have to object to your own decision, because Cyprus Republic is one. It's not the Department of the Immigration and something different than another department. You understand what I'm So, and this poor boy was forced to pay for a DNA test. He succeeded to the DNA test. The DNA test committed that from the Genetic Institute in Cyprus proves that he is the father, and the not only they didn't release the mother, but on the Saturday of 2 of November, he was arrested too. And I went to the immigration department 11 o'clock in the night. You have 5 policemen there arrest the big terrorist. And the officer there tell me, "Hey, Michalis, where is the child? We have to..." And I told him in his face, "Listen, I don't trust you. You are telling lies. I don't believe you that you care about this child, you or your supervisors, I don't know who are they. Okay? So don't tell me that you care about the child. You arrested the mother, you arrested the father, you dare to tell me that you care about the child? Okay, and the child now, by luck, only by luck, is with his uncle. Because the brother of these...
Well, he's lucky he's got an uncle here. Yes. Well, it's very worrying, Michalis, that this seems to be routinely going on day after day, time after time. Yeah. We will hopefully next week be talking to the Commissioner for Children's Rights on our programme, because it is International Children's Rights Day next Wednesday. So I'll be talking, I hope, to Lida Kursumba. We'll bring some of these things up then. It has been a pleasure talking to you,
thank
and
you
the very
you
best
very
of luck with your continued work.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you. And that is Michael Michalis Paraskeva, who is, as you could hear, a lawyer dealing very greatly with human rights and so on, and with deportation of migrants. So we've still got our computer news to come, and that's coming up before... No, we'll have a little piece of music in just a moment. Let's just... We have to announce to you, I think that's the right piece, that we will now be playing classical music for the rest of the programme, in between the interviews, of course, because we've just heard that Glafkos Kleridis has died. And we have for you, because this was not unexpected, an obituary.
During World War II, Glafkos Kleridis joined...